see how everything stands up.
Good. Yeah, I'm glad you guys are together. You guys busy?
Yeah.
So you decide to broadcast your dirty laundry and you're coming into my office during work hours to talk about our family issues?
What'd you say?
Seth, you are blowing this way out of proportion.
What did I say?
Seth, I told Seth that you sometimes want your brother. You want your brother relationship. He's all business.
This is called work, Karen. Together, you decide to broadcast your dirty laundry.
Seth,
Karen.
You are blowing this way out of proportion.
What did I say?
Seth, I told Seth that you sometimes want your brother. You want your brother relationship. He's all business.
This is called work, Karen.
I understand
that. So at work, we work.
I understand that, but we are still family, aren't we?
We are. But you know what? We handle family issues outside of work. So this is what we're going to do. Keep your phone on. 5 minutes after we close, I'll issue you a formal apology. Would that be good enough?
Yep.
He totally took that to a whole nother level. What is up with this formal apology? I will call you 5 minutes after the shop closes and issue you an apology.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Oh my gosh, what is this thing?
This is an elliptical, but on wheels, on steroids.
It's like it's not stationary, though.
It's not. You ride it.
It's supposed to be stationary.
You ride it.
Yeah. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is really cool. How fast does it go?
This thing can get up to 25 miles an hour. But I would.
25 miles an hour?
If you're really booking, if you're really exercising.
You really want me to put myself on this, don't you?
Yeah, yeah. Give it
I know you do.
We're going to time you.
So what are you going to do if I fall off of this, right?
Not get on it.
I don't know if I can get on this thing.
Just get the pedal in the right position. Just give yourself a little shove off and go. Pedal.
Oh.
There you go.
Oh, it is.
Oh, it's easy.
I could totally do this. Do you know how good of a workout this is? You're going to catch me, right? No way. I'm kind of digging this thing. Yeah, this is cool. How the hell you get off? Okay.
Like that.
Wow. Why do you want to get rid of it?
I'm going to buy a snowblower. We got a Michigan winter coming up here.
What do you want for it?
Well, I'd like to be somewhere around 1600 if I can get that for it. No. Well, give me your best shot.
What's the lowest you'll go?
That's a tough one.
I mean, I'm like under 500.
Oh, no.
I mean, that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
200?
1,200.
That's the lowest you'll go?
I'd keep it for that.
250?
They're not even close.
Well, that's the best I can do.
Well, it was great meeting you.
Yes, no, it was lovely meeting you, too. Yes. It was fun, right?
At least you got to ride it. So.
Yeah, I did. It's cool.
You look a little rough, though.
Oh, nice.
I was waiting for you to dump it.
No, if I would have dumped it, hopefully your ass would have came and got me off the ground.
I would have called somebody.
Let's go, buddy.
How you doing?
All right, how's it going?
Good, it's going good. What you got?
Stripper pole at stage.
A stripper pole. All right.
Interesting.
The stripper pole.
Homemade?
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
What are you guys looking to do with this?
Sell it.
Sell it? And how much are you looking for?
$300. I brought her to show you how sturdy
it
is.
Yeah, it works.
You need music?
Rich, you're next.
That's pretty good muscular control, isn't it?
See, and now this should subsidize your cost a little bit.
I'll go 150 because it looks like it might be something exciting. You dancing?
I'm not, but I gotta tell you. Are you interested in this? I'm serious. Are you interested?
We're gonna see. Maybe. It's more of a novelty.
No, come here for a second. You come here for a second? My brother and my dad sometimes need a female approach to different things here.
Thanks for bringing them.
Give me the $4 back. I'm kidding. People don't normally come in for stripper poles. Unless we can make a profit, I'm not buying it.
You can sell it.
Really?
Yeah. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Girls have these parties now, and they're like,
really?
Yeah.
Stripper parties?
That's what I was trying to tell you, but you went, you like, shut me up.
Really?
I'm sorry. Well, I thought you were going to make it more enticing, and I'd have to pay more money. Ashley's a great salesperson. She has limited negotiating power. Seth is an expert. You want 190? And keep the 5 hours that you got. I'll go 190.
All right.
Come on over here. Let's do it.
I think a lot of girls want stripper poles in their house because they're fun. So be sexy for your man.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
In case your friends have a stripper party. Don't invite me because I remember them when they were babies.
I've seen stripper poles sell for $500 and ours is going to sell immediately. I am so certain that this pole is going to sell. I'll bet you $20.
$20?
$20.
You're on.
I'll even bet you more because that's how certain I am.
How about 20?
20 is good.
20 is good.
How you guys doing? How can I help you guys?
I need a couple of jerseys for the office. What do you got?
Old English D, Detroit Red Wing style.
That's sweet.
Autographed by the entire team. This one's cool. Pearson and then Adai.
Oh, that's a Super Bowl jersey too. Nice.
That's awesome.
Maglio. Oh,
wow. Maglio, we're doing it. That'd be a good addition there.
These guys came in to look at a couple jerseys, and their eyes lit up once I started bringing them out. I had a hunch they'd consider buying more. Anything else?
My kid plays sports year-round, big athlete, basketball fan, big Lakers fan. Just looking for something unique.
I think I got something for you.
All right, let's see what you got. No way. No way.
Dude, Shaq Fu.
Wow, man.
I love that. It's awesome.
Pretty cool, right?
Are these his Lakers shoes?
Yeah, no, it is. I just got them certified. Not many people have
no doubt
his shoes.
All right.
So where are we at? We're interested in everything?
Yeah, absolutely.
You did do it all. Package it all together.
This is like a pawnbroker's dream. This guy wants everything. $3,250.
Let's go three.
Three for
all in.
Yeah.
$3,100.
I don't know. What do you want to do, bro? You can't do three?
That's fine. No problem. Yeah. Let's do it.
$3,000.
Appreciate it. $3,000.
Thanks, man.
No problem.
Yeah.
This guy's getting a great deal. Two shoes,
right.
The Dye jersey, Ordonia's jersey, Pearson, and the Winter Classic. And I can't believe I managed to sell the Shaq shoes. Thank God. Thank you guys for
awesome.
Stopping
awesome.
In. Seth, thank you very much.
Thanks, Helmut.
We'll see you. Nice meeting you. Yep.
So, Dad sent me out here to work with you. And since you're in such a crappy mood, I got this one. Oh, look, this should be fun.
Yep, should be fun.
We replaced the toilet in her house with one that's a low flow to save on the water bill, and we were looking at it and realized it's an original 1955 Elger. So, how much do you want for this toilet?
$400.
They don't make them anymore, and I saw a pink one online, and they wanted $600. So here's my thinking. Asking for the amount of money that you're asking for is really astronomical. So what are you coming down to?
Okay, two?
I think you're still astronomical. Keep going.
Why is my sister even negotiating? This isn't American jewelry and toilet.
From your house.
How about $50?
$10?
Oh, my goodness. Really?
Well, I don't want to put it back in the car. So, do you want it for $10? I know this is a crappy old toilet. Paying $10 to get under my brother's skin is all worth it.
Yes.
Sure.
Thank you much. Thank you.
Uh-huh. You can go write them up.
My sister has no idea how this business works. Who in their right mind is gonna buy something like this?
I don't wanna hear it. I'm in charge. I made the decision. $10.
Awesome. Bobby J, wheel it to the back, please. What the hell are you doing? So you give me all the time about buying stupid stuff.
Yeah?
You're gonna spend $10 on a toilet?
Yeah, it's
You're really $10. Gonna spend
$10.
This is what
it's
you do when $10. You're in charge.
Seth, do you understand how much toilets sell for nowadays?
Dude, it's a 1950s toilet.
You're gonna make a profit.
You're gonna make a profit?
Yeah, 100%.
Okay. Here's the deal. Would you like to double your money?
Who wouldn't? It's a toilet, Seth. Do you know it's a $10 investment?
Here's 20. Meet me outside.
Where are you going?
Go get Dad and meet me outside.
The dance floor is that way.
See you out there.
The dance floor is that way. Dad, come on, front, quick.
What's up, Ash?
Thank you for coming in.
That's fine. How long have the computer been down for?
The past, like, 2 hours. Please put your bag down and help.
You handle the floor, I'll handle the vault.
Fine.
I was so pissed off at Ashley, I wasn't even going to come in today. But the store's in trouble, and I need to help out.
Sarah, so what's going on?
I don't know.
Do me a favor. Shut down the computer system. I'm going to work on the server.
All right.
You got me f***ed up.
We have a computer problem. Be up in a minute.
No, I'm not waiting for the computers. I need my ring. I got my ticket right here. Just give
Sir,
me my ring.
What's the issue?
I need my ring.
Right. So as she very nicely stated to you, our computer system is down. We are trying to get it back up as quickly as we can.
I don't want
to
hear that. Come on. I put all this money down. I knew I shouldn't have come here.
Okay. We're getting it back up today. If you can just step aside so I can tell the other customers, and I'll be right out there, okay?
All right. 5 minutes.
Hey, let me see your pawn ticket. Hold on.
Yeah, man, I tried to turn my in here, paid my money, and they can't even give me my back.
I need this pickup. This guy's being very aggravated. It's a man's ring.
And then you try to get it back, and then all of a sudden they ain't got it no more. Their systems are down. You got me up around here.
Thank you. It's a lady's
ring.
Right.
It's not right. It's been printing up duplicate tickets. All I can tell you is buy me more time.
Oh, my God.
I don't know if it had to do with the crash, but our computer system's printing out duplicate numbers, which means two customers have the exact same number. I need to go through every packet to find this guy's ring. And if we don't fix it, we're
Hey, here's my right here. Hey, somebody, they got my ring right here. I found my ring. It's right here.
Are you for real?
Yeah, look at it.
Do you think your ring is the only ring that says 14 karat gold?
No.
Right.
But I'm just saying,
I know
exactly where it's at. It's right on the inside.
5 minutes.
No, that's my ring. You're playing me.
Your ring is still in my vault, and I can't get it out because our computer system is down. Once it gets turned back on, I'll be able to get your ring back out. So, do you want to leave because you're making a huge spectacle in here? Come back, and I'll have your ring for you.
We got 1 hour. 1 hour, I better have my this up. I want my.
You're gonna get it.
In 1 hour, you better have it.
Okay, have a good day.
All right.
Did you find a good?
Why don't you set up that guitar up here?
Great.
Why don't you set that right up here, too? Where are you guys from?
Detroit.
Oh, yeah? What brings you in the store today?
Bills.
We all got them.
These were my great uncle's guitars.
So, these were your uncle's?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And how long have you had them?
I've had them for 4 years.
For 4 years?
He passed 4 years ago.
Sorry to hear that. You okay, man?
Not really.
You're not getting rid of them. You can just get a loan on them, right?
No, we're going to sell them.
You want some?
We need to keep our house.
Got it. So, how much do you need?
$3,500 would put our bills intact. But we're willing to negotiate.
Right. How long have you lived in your house?
I've been in the household 30 years.
Oh, wow. And you guys work?
I did work. I'm retired now.
He's retired from Chrysler. This is my dad. I take care of him.
Right.
I'm sorry.
No, you're all right. Whoever had him enjoyed him.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. What will you guys take?
What is your price?
18?
18 of you. Okay.
You seem happy.
Thank you.
That'll help you out?
Yes. Thank you. That would help us out a little. Thank you so much. I'm a hugger.
No problem.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Thank you.
Absolutely. That'll help you guys out?
Yes.
Nobody knows guitars like my dad. Hopefully he can give me a little bit of insight on the serial numbers and the production years. Maybe it's worth something, maybe it's not. Whatever it is, I help these two people out. Thank you guys for coming back. So I got something else to tell you. I know those guitars mean a lot to you.
Yes.
Right? So it must have been really difficult for you guys to give them up. I have another offer that I'd like to put down on the table for you guys. You're welcome. So hopefully that helps you guys.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. So we appreciate you guys coming here.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you guys.
God bless you.
No problem at all.
Thank you.
Are you serious?
That was good.
That's good.
You did the right thing.
Hey, Seth, nice work.
Thanks, Dad.
I can't believe this. Oh my God. Thank you, Jesus.
It was the right thing to do.
It was the right thing to do.
Hey, man, I need to talk to somebody about this. This piece of junk I bought in here just a couple days ago don't work now. It's broken.
What is it?
Little ab lounger I bought here, man. Workout. Now, here it is.
I do see that you work out. Ain't no question about that.
And this thing obviously couldn't handle what I was doing on it. So 2 days later, it don't even work. So
you have your receipt?
I don't have a receipt. I didn't think I needed to keep it.
There's nothing I can do for you with that receipt. If you had the receipt, I could give you an exchange. I could give you something.
I don't want an exchange because it's probably going to be some again. How about you just get my money and then we won't have any more problems with this. But
I don't have any problems now.
Well, it could be a problem. I need my mother money back.
I understand that, and I'd like to give you your mother
money back. Gonna give you my money back.
I'm not gonna do anything.
You are.
I'm not gonna do anything.
And you can back off too, man. Like all this security standing around or whatever. I don't give a rat's ass about that.
Well, we don't give a rat's ass either.
I want my money. Like I said, there's no receipt.
There's no money.
There better be some money.
Or what?
Or what? There's gonna be a problem. How about that?
What kind of problem is there gonna be?
Here,
I mean, I don't need you.
Don't put your hands on me.
I don't need you. Give me no
ass. Talk like a gentleman. Go ahead, bro.
You give me the receipt, I'll be more than happy to
give you. Like I said, I don't have the receipt.
And I don't have the money.
Look here, man. You better back off too, man.
Don't touch him. Don't touch him.
Come on.
Come on, man. Let's go.
Really?
Let's go.
Hey, I told you, man. Let's go. Come on, fight with me. Come on outside.
We got you, buddy.
Bring a couple more. Come on.
We got you.
Bring a few more.
All we need
is bring all y'all out here.
Come on. That's it, buddy.
Come on. Bring five or six more out here. Come on. Bring a few more.
That's it, buddy.
Bring a few more.
That's it, my man.
Bring a few more.
Here's your machine, buddy. Don't come in here threatening us. We don't go for that. The bigger they are, the harder they fall. Remember that.
Who is this guy? I can't wait to hear what he has to say for himself.
Mr. Gold.
You must be Todd Hutchins. How are you, sir?
I am outstanding.
You sound exactly like you do on the telephone.
Nice. Hi, guys. It's a pleasure.
It's a pleasure meeting you, too. So explain to me how you got the paintings.
For the last 5 or 6 years, I've been buying and selling estates.
Okay.
And these were part of a big group of pieces that I bought. These pieces, let's be quite honest with you, I'm not an art person. I contacted a gentleman out of Chicago. He came down to St. Louis, gave us a peripheral examination, told us what he thought the pieces were, and I paid him $20,000 and he went back to Chicago.
This guy paid $20,000 to a guy in Chicago to see if these were fakes? It doesn't make sense. The way we did it was we had the Detroit Institute of Arts.
Very reputable.
Very. And they suggested me bringing in a gentleman to appraise it. And he gave us some information, which I'm going to be passing on to you.
Okay.
So let's bring him out.
Cool.
And we'll check it out.
Cool. That'd be great.
So he started off with this one.
Okay.
The Van Gogh. This piece, the actual one, is sitting in the Van Gogh Museum.
Very interesting.
This was the Picasso.
Right.
This one is not real.
Okay.
Then we go to the Marie Cassatt?
Cassatt.
It's not real.
Oh.
This pastel, this was printed on a really good copying machine.
Oh, so sad.
Yeah.
Chagall.
It's a copy. Now, this one could be real. Because of the paint strokes, because of the colors, this could possibly be real.
Now, I believe that it is.
Yes, this could be real.
Now, what do we need to do with those? You said these could be real. Do we want to do something with those?
So my thinking is that I give you an offer.
Yeah.
200.
Dollars?
Dollars.
$200. I can't do that less.
I have a quick question for
yes,
you.
Ma'am.
My job was to call Tory Auction House.
Okay.
And you said that's where these came from, right?
Right.
So your name never came up as a purchaser.
Yeah, it's weird because when we called, they're like, we have no record of that deal.
They don't know your company. They never made a sale on that day because I forwarded them all the information.
I don't know what to say, guys.
Yeah, weird.
Yeah, we don't know what to say either.
Yeah, that concerns me.
Yeah.
Listen, to be honest with you, this is one of the biggest scams I've ever seen.
I am not in the scam.
But why would your guy from Chicago not have been forthright to tell you?
He was. He was.
And he told you they were.
He told me they were no good.
So why wouldn't you have said that to me?
I did.
You didn't.
Les, I did.
Said that to me.
I did.
You didn't.
Les, I did. I said it could
be. But you knew it wasn't.
No, I never represented this was all real.
Yeah. Okay. I've had enough of this guy.
Rod, let's go.
These are my guys. They'll take them out for you.
Great. Appreciate it, guys. Again, disappointed. I wish
Believe
you
me, I'm probably
you.
More disappointed than you. Are you kidding me?
That's ridiculous.
This guy thought he could con me, but when there's $1 million profit, it puts a fog in front of my
Hi,
eyes.
How are you?
Good. Just looking at watches.
Anything in particular?
I see that diamond watch right here.
With the black leather band?
Yep.
Sure.
How much is this?
That one could be yours for $275. Would you like for me to help you put that on?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Let me help you do that. Here you go. See how that shines?
Oh, yeah, it looks nice. I think I'm just going to think about it.
Come back, and it'll be my pleasure to help you with any of these watches. Have
Thank
a
you.
Fabulous day.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Hey, Ashley. Wow. You had a lot of patience.
Listen, Karen, let's get one thing straight. I don't need your praise. I don't need anything from you.
Okay.
Let's have it understood, okay?
Okay. Yeah. I'm sorry to interrupt you guys. Rodney, can I talk to Seth for just
you
a second?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem, Rod. Yeah.
So you know how we're always saying we need more traffic in the store and we need to move product?
Okay.
I just did a pawn outside with a dunk tank, and I came up with this brilliant idea. We can use this dunk tank and we can have an event here.
Okay.
So, how about a three-ring circus?
I'm in favor of doing an event. No problem.
Right.
That's fine. But you need to sell it to the other two.
Perfect.
Fine. So let's go talk to them.
Thank you.
Anything to get the word out of American Jewelry and Loan, I'm going to listen to.
Hey, Les, you got a sec?
Sure.
All right, so Karen was just talking to me in the back, and I think she came up with a pretty good idea.
So, I want to have a three-ring circus here in the parking lot.
You want to put a circus outside?
Yeah. I'm trying to bring attention to the store.
Okay.
So I'm thinking if we have a huge event, do a circus theme.
A circus theme?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It'll be huge.
Mix it together with charities.
I mean, you think about it, the circus theme will draw in kids, right? And so kids
so you got
will
family.
Bring in parents, and parents will bring in money, and then the whole thing works.
Family spending money.
I like that. You know, people coming in spending money. Okay, do it. I think that you having this idea is really good. I have no
Great.
Problem with it, because I think it
yeah,
could work.
I think it's an excellent.
What are you guys, like, huddling about again?
So they came to me with an idea.
Ugh.
The idea was...
Here's the best part.
You didn't
even hear the idea, and already you're pushing
Because I can only imagine what her ideas are.
Well, it's a joint effort.
Right. I want to draw attention to the store. We've
okay.
all been saying that. We need more traffic.
Okay, what's your
we
idea?
We need to move product. A three-ring circus in the parking lot.
A three-ring circus in the parking lot? That's the dumbest idea I've ever heard in my life.
Well, it's just a circus theme. It's not going to be a circus. I mean, we're a professional pawn shop. You're not going to have a circus. I think they're onto something. You should join them and make it a great event.
Now you need my help.
You will help them, whether you like it or not. So I just wanted to tell you that this was a absolutely spectacular event. So I applaud you for your hard work. And believe me, Karen, you absolutely today were a superstar. This event
could not
have turned out better. It was absolutely spectacular. You really showed me how important this job is to you. I think we should all give Karen a round of applause for her great work. Really, it was great. You were terrific, really. It was a great, great day. Where are you going? Ashley? Ashley, talk to me about this, Ashley. Wait. What the hell was that all about? I'm having a meeting and you walk out without even stopping to talk to me? What the hell's wrong with you, Ashley? Ashley, what the hell is going on?
You want to talk, Dad? I'm ready to talk. I'm right here.
Lay it out, Ashley.
I'm sick of Karen. Since she started, you have told her how great she is, how fabulous she is.
I praise her when she does a good job, as I praise every employee when they do a good job.
She even screws up and you praise her. Instead of telling her what she does wrong, you tell me what I do wrong. You blame me even when she's made a mistake. And today, out of all days, she's telling me what to do? I don't think so.
She did a really good job with this event.
Please. I've had it up to here. Karen and I cannot work together. And because of that, it only means one thing.
And what is that, Ashley?
I quit.
You what?
I quit.
What do you mean you quit? Come back here. Ashley, come back now.